Hello, everyone. Welcome to another edition of Specialty Metal Smelters and Refining, video about metals. I'm here with Dan Fried, the Metal Man. I'm your host, Josef Katz. Today, we're going to talk about iridium, something that I don't think too many people are aware of. So, Dan, talk to me a little bit about iridium, what it is, where it's found, what it's worth, how you deal with it, so on.
First thing I have to say is that we get about 10 to 20 calls per week with everyone who thinks they have iridium because they x-rayed it. And these x-ray guns are flawed and they show iridium in everything. You don't have iridium if you x-rayed it. But that's another story.
So right. how do people know they have iridium or?
The best way is a lab test because it's a very rare element. And unfortunately, the only way to test it is in a lab. That's the only way.
So they should call you up, send you a sample
or send it to a lab.
Directly to a lab.
Yeah, there's a couple of good labs out there that take it and charge reasonably to test for it.
So where's it found? What's it worth? Why is it such a rare metal?
There's only 250,000 ounces of iridium mined per year, which is a very small number, very, very small number. It's used in spark plugs on aircraft. It's used in high temperature crucibles. It's used, believe it or not, well, they don't do it anymore, but they use it in expensive writing pens. The nib or the tip of the pen is made out of iridium. What else? Electronics that demand very high temperature elements. And it's very rare. Right now, Johnson Matthey is listing it at $4,600 an ounce. However, that's not what you're going to get. No one's willing to pay that much. You probably get more on the order of $2,200 to $2,700 per ounce.
And that's based on current trading prices, which will fluctuate.
Street price. No one wants to pay $4,600, which is a fictitious number set by Johnson Matthey.
And what is this metal used for now? Is there a demand for it?
Cell phones, electric vehicles, but there's not enough of it. That's why it's just not enough of it, but nobody wants to pay for it. It's a very strange situation to be in.
So is there a telltale sign that you may have iridium if x-rays don't work?
One of the most common forms of iridium is mixed with platinum. Jewelry scrap and electronic scrap used in electrophysiology catheter tips are typically 90% platinum and 10% iridium because it's used as an agent to a hardening agent to work with platinum. So jewelry, when you see many pieces of jewelry, it'll say right on the inside of it, 90, 10, or 90%, 10%, indicating that it's platinum with iridium.
All right, well, that's a good tip. So if someone has some platinum jewelry, they'll see a stamp in there, which may indicate that there's iridium, and then send it in for processing and you'll separate the two metals and pay them as appropriate.
Yep, that's how we do it.
Awesome. Well, if anyone has any questions, they can definitely give you a call. The number's on the screen, but it's 800-426-2344 or sales@speciallymetals.com. And we'll be back with another video soon. Dan, appreciate the insights on iridium, and I'm going to go check my jewelry drawer for iridium.
Very good. Thank you.
Take care. Have a great day.